Hey guys, and welcome back in a new video. How are you doing? I hope that you're doing great. I'm doing fine. In today's video, I'm so excited and happy to try a new clone of a popular clone brands, and I'm excited because this fragrance doesn't have any clone of it, which is the Jean Paul Gaultier Le Beau. I'm not sure yet if it's the Le Beau Le Parfum or Le Beau the Eau de Toilette, because I don't really know. This is like just a brand new clone. Not too many people talk about it, and I think I'm the first one to review, but I never tried it. I will do just the first impression and unboxing for now. The review will be coming later. I also did the unboxing of the Glacier Le Noir, the Le Mal Le Parfum clone. If you wanted to see it, you can find it on the channel. And before I start, I just want to thank you for your support. As always, it is what it makes me and motivates me to put more videos. Thank you so much, and like the video before you watch it so we get recommended to other people. And this is Glacier Bold. This is your presentation, a turquoise presentation in this nice can. This is a Jean Paul Gaultier clone from Alhambra, and I think this one it's going to be, I don't know, I have no idea to be honest, but let's start. And as I told you, I never saw a clone of the Jean Paul Gaultier Le Beau line, and since this is the first one, and it took them so much time for these clones brands to release a clone of it, I think because it's a hard fragrance to clone. Some of their fragrances like are not easier clone, and they give this time, and I think it's going to be good. But because when you don't rush things out, like they are going to be good. Let's start, enough talk, and let's check this presentation and stuff. This can is looking pretty nice. Okay guys, let's give the credit to this great looking presentation, great looking can. The feeling of it, it's not cheap. And by the way guys, this is $20 to $25. It is a really nice presentation, to be honest, for that price. The coloring and everything is nice. You have the gold writings with the turquoise color and stuff. I think it looks super good, especially for the price. You have that batch of your Alhambra here, your Alhambra there, to know it's an authentic. Just don't worry, you will not get a fake from Alhambra, because I don't think they have fake fragrances. Wow, what a great, this looks definitely great. Look guys at this presentation, don't you think that it is good? Just look, this is absolutely gorgeous. Like the bottle, the turquoise, like it's degraded, it's in here black, and right here is the black like a turquoise green with this pouch, with this nice feeling. To take care of the looking, like the bottle details at this price, they know that they also took care of the fragrance itself. I think this is the clone of the Le Beau Le Parfum, because the original Le Beau is just it doesn't have any degradation. It's just a green turquoise looking bottle. The Le Parfum, which I will leave the picture right there, it's the one with this black thing and stuff going right there. Enough talk guys, let's check the cap is just plastic and golden. It feels not light but not heavy at the same time. The bottle, the sprayer, the writing, everything is looking great for me, to be honest. The bottle is really thick, it does have a nice feeling to it. The quality is amazing. Enough talking, let's start, check the fragrance itself and check the sprayer, and I will let you know about this fragrance. Yeah, let's start. But with a sweetness and with a mature sweet vibe to it, it's a little bit different. Because I tried the Le Beau and I tried the Le Beau Le Parfum, but Le Beau Le Parfum I didn't give it like a lot of time. But I'm so familiar with the Le Beau the Eau de Toilette. Anyway, this is a nice sweet tropical coconut. It does have mango, pineapple, coconut, salted woods, like a salt vibe to it, marine salt and salted woods with coconut, pineapple, definitely mango, a lot of mango, and probably peach. Let me give you another spray in the air and see. Yeah, guys, this is absolutely gorgeous. I'm blown away, just like I was blown with this one right here, the Glacier Le Noir. I'm just blown away. This is a super clean quality, clean scent. The composition of the fragrance is absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. The bottle look, this is definitely worth it. Guys, if you see those in a website or something, and also if you see the Glacier Ultra, the Ultra Marcolin, buy them all, because I'm sure these ones are good. And the Glacier Ultra, the Ultra Marcolin would also be good, because there's already the Lam's La Chaffa Silver, the clone of Ultra Mal. I think the Glacier Ultra is going to be better, because the quality in here, I just think that it has a better quality than their normal. I don't know, I just smell something really good in here. Absolutely gorgeous. The coconut, the mango, the peach, the pineapple, the salted woods, the iris, a little bit of a floral vibe, the tropical. You will feel like if you are in a tropical island or something. This is actually super good. I'm so in love with this. I will wear a lot of this fragrance right here. Super great. Again, I'm not hyping anything. You will try it, you will see it by yourself. This is mind blowing for the price. And this is just like for now. Alhambra fragrances, when they come out, they be for like $20 to $25. But like when you give them time, where I live, I could get this for $15 to $20. That's amazing for a fragrance like this. If you see this even for $40, go and buy it, because it is super good. So what are you going to smell? Is a really sweet tropical mango, pineapple, coconut combo with a powdery lactonic vanilla vibe with the salted marine woods. This is a beautiful DNA of fragrances. I love this stuff right here, especially for the price. I think it is super good. When I tried the Lobolo Parfum for the first time, the real thing, I didn't like it so much because it was expensive and I thought that it didn't deserve the $100 price tag. But for a $20-$25 price tag for this one, it is super good. I don't know yet about the performance and the longevity. I will try and give it maybe like 2 to 3 wearings and let you know. Again, this is so close to Le Beau. This is a perfect clone. People who tried Le Beau and the Le Beau DNA, they will try this and they wouldn't be able to pick a difference. I think the difference is just because I'm still not sure if it's the clone of the Le Beau Le Parfum or Le Beau the Eau de Toilette. I think it's a mix of both together in one bottle. But anyway, I think it does have a twist to it. I still can't pick it up, but it's so nice. Maybe the mango. I'm not sure if Le Beau has mango. I think it did. Yeah, it was so tropical. So if you want to smell like a mango with peach, with pineapple, with coconut, but still with a masculine touch, nothing unisex about this fragrance. This is so still super masculine. The iris with the vanilla, with the woods, give it a masculine touch. With the tropical vibe from the peach, the mango, the pineapple, the coconut. This is absolutely beautiful. I can't get enough of this one. Let me give you another spray. This is beautiful. Oh damn. It's super nice for the price. I think this new releases from Alhambra for the Jean Paul Gaultier clones are super good. I hope that they will have a good performance just like the La Chaffa fragrances, because I noticed something that with Alhambra clones, the performance is not as good as the La Chaffa clones. But anyway, the scent is still better than La Chaffa for me. Just because La Chaffa sometimes they twist things with that woody Arab vibe. But this one right here smells so European, so Western-like, so good, so nice. I will try the longevity and give those full wearings and let you know if it's gonna have a better performance or just a similar performance. I hope that they will have a good longevity because I'm really in love with this scent. And in which season you can wear this one, I think this line right here, this fragrance right here, is perfect for the summer, spring and fall. The only time you can't wear this one is probably the winter, because I don't think it can cut to the winter cold or sun or like stuff like that. But for the summer, the spring, the fall, this will be absolutely amazing. And this scent right here, I just don't want to make this video long, so I can give you another video of this one for the full review where I try it and try it really good, and I will let you know everything. But this one, I feel like it does have something different. It does have a complicated vibe to it, a sophisticated thing going on. I think it's the iris, probably the iris that they put in this one with that, I don't know, still a really really good solid fragrance. Which one do I prefer, this one or the Le Male Le Parfum? I think it's the Glacier Noir Le Male Le Parfum Cologne. If I gave that one a 10 out of 10, I would give this one a 9 or a 9.5 out of 10. Doesn't mean that it is bad, but it just means that Le Male Le Parfum Cologne is just amazing. This is amazing too. But I'm more into the winter scents. They have a depth to it, to them. And this, the Glacier Le Noir is definitely so, so good. And it does have that depth, that thing that I was looking for. So good. A really nice type of a fragrance. So guys, this was the video, this was the unboxing. Stay tuned for the review. Like this video, subscribe if you are not subscribed yet in my channel. Anyway, I think the summary of these videos that I made lately is just that Alhambra is knocking things out with these Jean Paul Gaultier clones. Like, if you tried the Alhambra, the Tom Ford clones, you know that they are good. I think these ones are even better in my eyes. I just don't know why. I think I'm more into those masculine sweet scents because the Tom Ford clones were a little bit unisex. But I think that these ones are like top notch, just like the Alhambra, the Tom Ford clones. If you try them, these ones are definitely good. Go and pick them up, guys. And thank you so much for watching this video, and see you in the next video.